Okay, so we are going to start the training. So please shut down your mic. Okay, so I am the trainer. I am a Autodesk certified instructor. So I have done my engineering from the LPU college, and I have 6 years of experience in the teaching of these technical educations. And before that, I was working with the companies to create the drawings, to create the 3D modeling, to create the CNC programs of the machine, or the drawings. Okay, I have conducted 100 plus workshops in different colleges, including NITs. Okay, and I have also trained around 2000 plus software plus students in different softwares. Okay, so this session is for AutoCAD. I am also conducting a training session on SolidWorks and Creo. Okay, so you can join other sessions too. So starting with the AutoCAD is a software of Autodesk company, and Autodesk is a US based company which have so much software, around 400-500 softwares in the different fields like analysis, 3D modeling, animations. Okay,
if I give a float left, then the contents, each and every content will be on the left side.
Please turn off your mic.
This content will first be inserted, and then this content will be inserted, and it sees the left side, and this content will be inserted. Next, LI, A we are given, then the,
okay.
This link.
Okay, Pavneet Singh, please close your mic. Ramandeep, please close your mic.
Drop down.
And
Jatin. Name is a main class.
Okay. So you can see here AutoCAD is the software of Autodesk, and it is worldwide used for 2D drafting only. AutoCAD can create 3D models, but we don't use AutoCAD for the 3D modeling because it is a non-parametric software. Okay, so what is the parametric? Parametric softwares are those who can update the product or the assembly at any time. You can create a change in drawing, you can create a change in part, you can create a change in assembly, and that change will reflect in every module. Okay, so we will see in AutoCAD also how to create the parameters manually. Okay, so second thing is productivity tools. So after creating a drawing, after creating a fully defined drawing, we can store the drawing in the library. We can create a library for ourselves to use the product repeatedly. If a company uses a product regularly, and we can save that product in a library and create or use or edit that product repeatedly. You can see there is an option in left side where we have the option like imperial samples and metric samples. We can use those samples also. Okay, so we are going to start the training. So we have the AutoCAD software here. We have two versions, 2016 and 2019. You can install any version. The latest version of AutoCAD is 2021. If you have a system that is capable of handling 2021, that will require a minimum of 8 GB RAM, i5 processor minimum. So you can install that, or you have 4 GB RAM with i3 processor, you can simply try 2018-17 or below that. Okay, so 3-year license of the software is available on the website of the Autodesk. We have already shared the link with you. You can download the software from there. If you face any problem, please contact us through the group. Okay, so if you have any queries, please, related this session, you can ask in between by opening your mic, and please ask after asking the question, please mute your mic. Okay, so simply open the software from here. Just double click and the software will open. If you face any problem, your software is not opening, simply right click here, go to properties, go to the compatibility, and you can run in compatible mode. Okay, here is the option compatibility. Run this program in compatible mode, and you can select the compatible option. Okay, if you face any problem, you can do this, or you can just message us in the group and we will follow your query. Okay, so what kind of drawings we make, what kind of work we do in the AutoCAD. So for the sample, I'm going to show you some sample files. Okay, so here is a sample. You can see this is a file. I have a copy, it's not a original file. I have a photo of this drawing. The photo was clicked through my phone, so there are some missing areas. So you can see there is a template. You can see the template. There is a title block in which all the details are given. Okay, and then we have the views. We have the isometric view. We have the orthographic views. It's the first angle projection. We can draw in the third angle projection also. You can see the symbols here. Okay, you can see that units specified in the mm. You can see the company name and the logo and the drawing number. Everything is given here. Okay, every detail is given here. So we are going to create these type of drawings here. You can create isometric as well as orthographic view. Okay, and you can define complete dimensions of, and you can also proper label the drawing. Okay, these type of drawing we are going to create. And there are other options. If you want to create an assembly, you can do that here. In 3D modeling, you can define the bill of materials here. You can define the balloons here. Okay, so everything will be done. You will be able to create these all things after this training. This training will be covered in 5 days, and we are going to complete only drafting part, not 3D modeling part. Okay, so back to the software. So after opening the software, the first home screen will be like this. We have the start screen here, in which we have option for start drawing, to open the files, to open the recent files here, or to connect with the Autodesk account. Okay, so Autodesk account option is enabled here because due to this, you can just sign in here and you can use it as your email, or you can save all your files on that account and access those files in different system without carrying the files. Okay, so it is a helpful thing. You can always sign in here. So there is an option. This is called application button or application menu. You have lots of options here, but right now we have some few options because we are in start menu option right now, start mode right now. If we create a drawing, then we have so much options available here. You can create a new again, you can open a recent file or previous created file, you can save the current file, or you can save the current file with a different name, in a different format. Okay, you want to save your file in PDF format, you can do that. You want to save with other format like DWT, DWS, DFX, DXF, DWG, any other format you want is available in this software. If you want to import the after 2017 versions, we have an option to import a PDF drawing. Okay, that PDF will be converted into DWG file. Okay, before that we don't have that option. We have to create the drawing manually. But after 2017, including 2017, we can import a PDF and that can be converted into a drawing. We have to create some changes. We have to make some changes to adjust, but we can import most of the PDF. Again, there is an option to export, to publish, to print, and for utilities. Utilities include the option like units. You want to audit, you want the status of the file, you want to remove some objects, some files from the drawing. If your file got corrupted, then you can recover your file from here. So much options are available in this option. So there is an option. This option is the setting of the software. You can click here or you can open it by command panel. So from here you can control all the setting of the software. You want the display to be light in color, you want some theme changes, you want to change the color of the lines, you want to change the appearance, you can do everything from here. Okay, so after opening a file, you can see we have tab option. You can switch tabs from here. you have a file name right here or you have a file name right here. Okay, so first this is application button. Second, we have a quick access toolbar. You can read the name here, quick access toolbar. To quickly access the commands, you can add them through here. If you want a layer command right here, you can do that. Suppose I want this workspace right here, I can just click on here and the workspace will be added right here. Okay, then other option, new, open, save, save as, and also we have an option open from web and mobile. You can access AutoCAD through mobile and online also. Then save to web and mobile, you can save your file directly to your mobile. You can plot, printing option again, and to undo or redo a step, you can select these options here. To change the working space, work area, right now we are in drafting and annotation. So we are seeing here the drafting tools. If you select the 3D option, we will see the 3D tools right here. Okay, so this is the workspace, we can control it from here. Next, we have some option here. We can search any command, any help if you want, you can search from here. You have a sign in option and then you can minimize, maximize from these options. Next, we have a ribbon tab, ribbon bar, where all the tools are given. The name you can see here is ribbon. Okay, so ribbon bar consists all the tabs, all the panels. In the ribbon, first we have the home panel, home tab, in which the tools are specified by the workspace. Okay, then other tabs, if you want to insert anything, we have the insert tab. If you want to annotate anything, if you want to detail the drawing, you want to assign the dimension, you want to enter the text, you can go through here. Then if you want to apply some parameters, we have the parametric tab also. So many tabs. We are going to start with the home tab. Then in the home tab, we have some panels. In panels, you can see there is a draw panel. If you want to draw anything, it's like your pencil. You want to draw anything, you can draw here. You want to draw a line, a rectangle, a circle, an arc, anything you want, is you can do it from here. Okay, then there is a modifier. You can modify the objects you have created from here. First you have to create something, after that you can modify them. Suppose I have a rectangular shape, I want to move the rectangular shape, then I can move it from here. If you want a copy, I have an option to create multiple copies. If you want to rotate anything, you have an option here to rotate the object. Okay, so these are the modifiers. We will cover them in the second session. So in first session, we will cover these draw tools. Next, we have some option for annotations. Annotations means you want to define the dimension of this object, then there are options for dimension right here and right here. You can simply select the object and the dimension will be defined, but the size of dimension is very less right now. We can manipulate that after some time. Okay, right now you can see there is the dimension, it's 6720. Okay, so if you want to enter any text, you want to type any text, there is an option for text command. If you want to create a table, there is an option for the table. Simply create like this. Okay, right now I am just going through some introduction. We will start in 5 minutes after this introduction. Next, we have some tools here. Okay, this is our working area where we will create our drawings. Okay, so next, after in this working area, we have some options. First, you can see here is the coordinate system. If you want to draw according to your coordinate system, you can use this. Then we have some views. You want to create in top view, front view, you can choose from views. If you want to change the visual style from 2D to 3D, there are so many options for 3D modeling. But by default, it should be 2D because we are using AutoCAD for 2D drafting. So it should be 2D wireframe and view should be top. Then there are some options for navigation. You can pan the screen right like this. You can zoom on this. You can orbit, rotate in the 3D. You can see the plane in 3D right now. Okay. Sometimes this will happen. So always save your file first, because if this error occurs, your file will be not saved. Okay, I'm going to restart my software. Okay, through books, you don't need books to learn the AutoCAD. You can simply go to YouTube, or you can simply join some training, so you can get the idea of the intermediate level of AutoCAD. Okay, so in the intermediate level, you will able to draw these type of drawings. Okay, this is a sample drawing. In the intermediate level, you will learn how to create isometric drawings. How to create balloons like this, how to create text, and how to create bill of material. It is the intermediate level. Okay. So you can see here, we can pan, you can zoom. If you are like this, you lost your drawing, just simply click on this option, zoom extend. All the screen will be covered with the drawing. Okay, your drawing will be fully zoomed in this area. Next, we have orbit option. We can rotate it in 3D. So select orbit option. You can press and hold left mouse button, and you can drag your mouse right like this. So it is an orbit option. It is used for 3D modeling, not in 2D drafting. So simply you have to select top view from here, and your screen will be parallel to the your laptop screen. Okay. So next, we have a command line here. We can control all the software from this command line. If you want any command, you can just type here. Okay. You don't need to clip in this option. You can just type. You type anything that will be written here, that will be entered here. Okay, if you want a command, like you want to activate the circle command, just type C. Okay, and you can see there is a list. So you want a circle. If the command is in first option, you can always press enter, and that command will be activated. Okay, so we are going to create a new file right now. So you can type any command. You want a rectangle, simply press R. Rectangle starts from R. So in first option, we don't see the rectangle. We can select E. Again, we don't get the rectangle. Then we type C. So you can see the shortcut for rectangle should be REC. You can always select from this list, or you can type REC and press enter. The command will be activated. So you can draw a rectangle. After that, if you accidentally close this command line, you can always get it back to control 9. Okay, you have to press the combination of control 9. You can see here. Next, we have the option of model and layouts. Basically, model where you create all the models of all the drawings. We will be covering the circle in few minutes. Wait for a few minutes. Okay. In the model tab, you will create all the drawings, and in the layout, you will create the layout. You will set the printing. Okay. You will create the drawing for printing from layout. Okay. In the model, you will create drawing. You can create multiple drawings, but if you want to print a single drawing from that multiple drawings, here model, you can always go to layout and you can set the setup here, and you can print. Okay, you can use the templates from here. like this. And you can see we have an additional template, and in the template you can see there are the attribute blocks available. You can always insert the views from this window. So we will cover the layouts in the last section. Next, we have the status bar here. In the status bar, we have so many options, like you want to see this grid from here or not. We have the option to turn it on or off. Then we have snap option and many more options. We will be covering this step by step in this session. So first thing we are going to cover is how to set up the units. Okay, the first thing every drafting person or every draftsman will use is units. So after opening the file, you have to just select the unit. You can select it from here. Okay, we have the option of units here. If you don't see your option here, you have to just click on these three lines and the list will open. You have to just select the units from here. You can see I have already selected, so the checkbox is enabled. If I disable, then the unit will not be here. So select the units from here and you can select it from this list. Okay, in the list we have many options. For mechanical engineering, you have to select the decimal, because in India we use metric system. Many countries use IPS system, inch pound system. In that case, you can change the dimension from the unit command. Okay, or you can select the engineering, and in that you can specify the inch option. Or you can select the architectural or fractional or scientific, whatever you want. But most of the cases we use decimal. So how can you set the unit from this option also or other option? We have the other option called unit. Simply type the UN and press enter. A dialog box will open of drawing units. In the length type, you can see there is the option of decimal, and the insertion scale of that is millimeter. So every value we type the value in millimeters. If you want to change to inches, to feet, you can always do that. Next, we have the angle option. So in an angle option, we have the decimal degree selected. And the precision is the value that we use after the decimals. So in mechanical engineering, we use up to 4 digits. Okay, so it is required. If you choose like this 0, so if you enter the value 22.57, so you will see the value 23. The values will round off by default because you have not selected the precision in this. So always select the precision. In mechanical engineering, we use the precision up to 4 digits. Okay, so whatever precision you need, just select it from here. So select OK, our units are set. Now you can start the drawing. So for a reference purpose, I am going to open a drawing. Okay. So here we have a drawing here. You can see we have a origin given 0, 0, and we have a line. Its length is 3 plus 2, 5. This line, its height is 3. This line is 2. This line is 7 minus 3, 4. So you can calculate all the dimensions from here. So to draw this object, this drawing, you have to simply go to the software. Okay. And now you can see that these all are lines. So we can simply use the line command from here. Okay, or you can use the shortcut, simply press L and you can see the line is selected. Press enter and it will show you the line option of the line. So in the line, you have to specify the first point. So the first point we have is from 0, 0, from the origin. You can, if you want to use the origin, you can. If you don't want to use the origin, you also choose for that. Okay, so simply click on any point. Line will be started. So after that, we have option here, specify next point or undo. Okay, so in this drawing we need to set the first point to origin, so I'm going to select the undo. So there is the option again, specify first point. So if you have a mistake, if you do a mistake, you can always undo that mistake by simply selecting the undo. So to specify the first point, we have the origin. So we will type that value 0, 0 and press enter. You can see the line is starting from the origin right now. After that, there is an option called specify next point. So next point, we can see that this line is of 5 millimeter length and this line is horizontal. So you can see that if you enter a 5 length, the line will not be made horizontally because we didn't specify the angle. So select the undo. So if you have the line in horizontal or vertical axis, you can simply select a command called ortho mode. We have this option here, ortho mode. The shortcut is F8. You can choose from F8 or simply turn it on from here. So you have to just specify the direction. Which direction do you want? Okay, and after that you can specify the value. So I have to specify the value of 5. Press 5 and press enter. You can see the length of 5 is created. Now you have to create a second line. The line is 3 millimeter in length. So I have to specify the direction and I can specify the value for 3 mm. So in this way we can create. So simply direction, define the value, direction, define the value, direction, define the value. Okay. So right now I have entered 40 by mistake. So undo and define the direction and press value. Again, press enter the value and press enter. Now you can always press enter the value here. You know the value is 7. You can always enter the value here like 7, enter, and the object will be completed. And if you want to exit out from the command, you can always press the escape button. But you can also apply a command from here that is called close, that end point and the start point will be joined together. Like if I select the close command like this. Okay, so simply select the line, start, select the start point, use the direction method, use the value. Okay, and to complete, to close the object, simply use the close option from here. You can see that the text close contain a letter in blue color. Whichever letter is blue in color, you can simply type that letter. Like I have typed a C letter here. And if I press enter, the close command will be activated and will be applied on that object. So any query up to this? If you have any queries, please ask your question or I will move further. Okay. So next we will cover how can we use the dimension on this object. So there is an option. We can see in annotation, we have an option here, dimension, and we have an option here that is types of dimension. Okay. So we can either select it from here or either we can select it from here. So first we are going to choose this dimension. And after that, we have to just, for length, we have to just go to the object. Okay. As I go to the object, you can see a dimension will be created if I click here. Okay, so I click here and now there is an option to place the dimension. You can always place, you want to place it here, here, any location you can choose. So I'm placing it right now here. So now you can see the size of the dimension is very much large. So I have to control the size. To choose the size, press escape to exit out from the command, and to change the size of the dimension, simply press D for dimension and enter. After pressing the D, there is an option called Dimension Style Manager. We can modify everything, every type of dimension, everything, every property of the dimension from the Dimension Style Manager. We can control the arrow size, the arrow type, the dimension size. So just open this dialog box, go to the modify and go to the fit. We can change individually everything. We can change the type of text, the color of text. We can change the size of arrow, the type of arrow. We can change the color of line or size of line. Every property can be changed, but we will go to the fit because we don't want to disturb the symmetry of complete drawing dimension. So go to the fit and use the overall scale from here. Okay, if I press the scale 0.1, okay, we by default we have the scale 1. I know my dimension is big, so I have to scale it down. So I will scale it down to 0.25. okay, so select OK, press set current and press close. So our dimension will be converted to, the scale of the dimension will be changed according to the scale we have provided. Okay, so to apply the other dimension, go to the dimension tab, simply go to the line and you can specify like this. Next option is, please don't share your screen. Okay, so next type of dimension, how can we specify? Right now we are just going to the object and we can specify the length like this. But if you don't have this line and you want to specify the distance between these two lines, you can simply go to the line, just click here. You can see there is the length of the line. I don't want the length, I want this gap. So you have to just go to the other object like this, and you see the box here, just click on this and you will get the dimension like this. So you can always create by multiple types. Third type is, you can choose the end point like this, choose this end point and you can specify the dimension. And after that you can specify like this. Okay, so now you can see that I have specified length for every line, but in this drawing the dimensions are not specified for the every object. Okay, because we can see that this 3 and 4 will be equal to 7. So if we enter, if we define the 7 or 3 alone, we don't need this 4, the drawing can be created. Or if we choose these two, again the drawing can be created. Or if we choose these two, again the drawing can be created. So we don't need to specify every value, we have to just specify the minimum required dimension. Okay, so you have to see that whatever dimensions you will provide is minimum required dimension or not. Okay, so like this, I have to specify the dimension of this box. So simply I can specify like this. Okay, so in this way you can create a fully defined object. Right now I am not defining the location of this object, like from where or how much distance in between this point or this point. If you want that distance, you can always specify it from here. Okay, like we have given 0, 0 right here. So how can we specify? We have the different option here. We have the linear type, we have the align type. What is the difference in between that? So we have the line option. Okay, so I'm creating a line right now in an angle. So if I create a dimension by selecting this object, you can see this line is, this dimension is of aligned type. This is the actual length of this line. But if I want to see that object from the front, I want to use the vertical dimension. So just go to this dimension and select this object. And you will get the aligned. Now go to the outside of the object and you can see there is the vertical dimension. If you want the horizontal dimension, just go to the downside of that object and you will got the horizontal dimension. So these dimensions are called linear dimension and these dimensions are called aligned dimensions. Okay, you can always specify both type of dimension from dimension types, or you can just choose from here linear and aligned. So that type of dimension will be created. Okay, to specify the origin, we can always use a command called ordinate type dimension. If you are already on origin, you can just click here, a dimension will be created, and repeat the command, click here, and a dimension will be created here. You can see that this origin is at 0, 0, or you can simply type the text. Yes, you will get the recorded video to YouTube. Okay, and I'm going to take the attendance at the end, so please don't leave. Okay, so you can always type a text from here. You can just click here and type in a bracket 0, 0 and click outside. Okay, so scale is large. You can simply select the size from here like this. Okay, any question in drawing dimension? You can ask your question by unmuting your mic if you have any. We have a question here that how did we set units, if you can repeat for architectural purpose. Okay, if you want to set for architectural purpose, just click here and you see the architecture, just click here and the architecture will be set. Okay, now you can just click here and if you want a 8-inch line, just press F8. You can see the dimension type are now in inch and feet. Just type 8 with inch and enter. The line will be of 8 inches. Now check the dimension. Now you can see there is the dimension. Simple 8 is written. We go to the D, enter, modify, and we go to the primary units. Right now it's decimal. You see the architecture here. Okay, set current and flow. You can see the value in inches right now. We can always change the dimension to the other types. Okay. So right now we only need the decimal type. You can always show it like this. Last thing was units, coordinate system. Okay, I have just written the text here for the coordinate. You can simply type the text from here. We have the annotation tab and we have the text command right here. Go to the text. Okay, you can see the text here. Now you have to just create a box where you want to write a text. Okay, after that, a text manager will be open, a text editor will be open. So now you can just select the size from here. I want it 1 meter and type from here 0, 0 bracket close, and just click the outside of the this box, click outside of the box, and the command will be completed. Okay. Clear now, or I should repeat? Okay. So, in this way, you can create a line drawing from the line command and you can specify the dimension. Next, we have a command called polyline. This is a similar command of like line, but difference are few here. So specify first point, specify next point, similar option. Okay. Please turn off your mics.
Training.
Let's go.
Yes, Jatin, please turn off your mic. Ch.Sai Kumar. Okay. Okay, so right now I have created this object with the polyline command and I have created this object with the line command. If I select the object, you see I can select only one object, but if I select this object created by polyline, I can select the whole object just by just clicking once. Okay, so what is the difference? Polyline is a joined line type. Okay, if you create a line like this, it is a single entity. Okay, if you create a polyline like this, it is a joined entity. Every line is joined to other line. Okay, so if you select both, you can always see that in this line we have the option, this point, these points are called grips. You can see there are the options stretch vertex, add vertex and remove vertex. And if you go there, there are the options stretch and lengthen. You can change the length of this line. You can stretch this point. This is the lengthen. This is the, if we turn off the ortho, this is the stretch. Okay. If we go here, you can stretch. You can add vertex, a new point. You can remove vertex. Okay. And if you see at the center, we have again a grip here similar to this, and we can just move the object from there. But here we have multiple options. There are options to stretch, so you can see that these two lines are connected to this line, and they will always be connected to this line. So you can stretch, you can add a vertex from here, means you can convert this line into two lines. So like this, you can see there is another line, so you can remove, and there is an option you can convert it to the arc like this, or if it is an arc, you can convert it to line. So these are the options that you can see in the polyline. If you want to create a line type, if you want to create the entities from line to polyline, you can simply do that. You have to just select the object. To select the object, you have to just click here, or you have to click, and you see there is a color, green color, that is called cross polygon, and in the right side we have the color blue, that is window polygon. In the cross polygon, if you touch any object, that object will be selected. But in the window polygon, if the object is not completely in the window, the object will not be selected. You can see this object is highlighted because it is touching the blue, green box, but in this is not completely in the box. But if I go down there, and now you can see the object is completely in the box and it can be selected right like this. So this is cross polygon, this is window polygon. So simply we have to just select the object, and if we press J for join and enter, you can see that this object is now converted to a polyline. Now this object has also the option of a polyline. You can convert it into the arcs, you can convert it to the line. Okay. Next, we have the option of circles. You can create many types of circles from here. So to create a circle, we need a radius or a diameter first. If you don't have radius or diameter, then we need some references. So first two options require the radius and diameter. So first option, you can see there is an option called center and radius. We need the center location of the circle, we need the radius of the circle. So I need a circle that is coincident, that the circle center is coincident at this point and the radius is 10. So I'm selecting center radius. After that, you can see specify center point for circle. I have the center point right here. After that, there is an option called specify radius of circle. I have the radius 10 millimeter. Enter. You can see that the circle is created, and if you select the dimension and go to that circle, okay, try not to get here, just go to this point, and you can see that the dimension in diameter will be defined. If you want the radius dimension, just go to here, select the radius type, select the object, and you can see the radius type dimension. Okay, now if you select the circle, you get the grips. 5 grips will be available. First is the center point. You can always move from the center point. Next is the quadrant grip. You can always change the value from here. You can always change the size from here. Okay. So this was the first type. If you have the radius of the circle and the center, you can create it like this. Next, you can choose from here, or the shortcut is C. Circle start from C. So type C, then there is the first option of circle, press enter. Okay, now there are a few options. Specify center point for circle, and other options are there. You can choose 3 point, 2 point, or tangent radius option. You can see we have 3 options here, but in here we have 6 options. So 3 point, 2 point was available here, tangent radius was also available. But we didn't see the radius and diameter option, because for that we have to specify the center first. You can see there are only 2 options that require center radius and center diameter. To specify the center first, you will get those 2 options. But for the tangent option, 3 tangent option, we need to go to this option. We need to go to this, and we have to select it from here. After that, we can create it. Okay, so I need a diameter type. So I have to specify the center first. My circle center is here, and I need a diameter type. So you can see it is asking for specify radius of circle. So, but I don't want to specify the radius. I want to specify the diameter. So you can select the diameter from here, or you can just type D, because D in blue color. Select the diameter, enter the value of the diameter. I want a 10 dia circle. So press enter, and the circle will be created like this. Okay, and again you can check the dimension from here, and this way you can create a circle. Any question regarding this? Okay, next option we have is 2 point. So if you have 2 point references, like I want my circle to be coincident at this point and this point, so select the 2 point. Select the first, select the second point, and the circle will be created like this. No value will be required, just 2 point needed for this. Okay. Next, we have an option for 3 point. Suppose our circle is coincident at this point, and this point, then we need 3 point circle. Select the 3 points like this, and the circle will be created without any value, just 3 references required. After that, we have an option called 2 tangent and radius. Suppose we need a circle that is tangent to these 2 lines, and we have the radius of 5 mm. So we can select option from here, tangent radius. Just select the first tangent, select the second tangent, and specify the radius. I need a radius 5. So you can see 5 radius circle is created. If you need a lower radius, specify the command, first tangent, second tangent, I need a radius of 1. So type here, you can see the circle is tangent to both the lines, and the radius is 1. Okay, and the last option is, if you need a circle that is tangent to both 3 lines, then you can specify the 3 tangent option, select the points, and 3 tangent will be applied without any value, the circle is created. Okay, any question related circles, please ask your queries right now. Okay, no questions, then we are going to create a drawing. sir, how to switch between specific directions. Okay, when you select a command circle, C enter, when you specify a center, okay, after specifying the center, it will always ask for a radius. If you want to switch to diameter, just click here on the diameter. Okay,
you can create it like this.
Okay, so next we are going to create a drawing right now. Okay, so if we have to create this drawing, this is a rectangular shape. We can create a rectangular shape through lines. The size is 48 by 241, and we have some circle size are given, and the centers are a few distance away from the center of this line. So first we have to create a rectangular shape. So is my screen visible to everyone? Can you see the movement in my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then your screen is, your internet is slow. Please try to reconnect. Chandni, please try to reconnect. Okay, so next we have to create a rectangular box. So for that I am using line right now. So specify the first point. Now turn on the ortho mode for straight lines. Okay, and now we can specify the value 48. Press enter. Specify the direction. Specify value to 41. Specify the direction. Specify value 48. And you can press the close button, and the object will be created. Okay. Now dimensions. So this is 48, this is 41, size is very less, so go to D, enter, modify, fit option, and change the value to 1, okay, set current and close. So again this is small, so go to the dimension again, change the value from 1 to 4, okay, set current, close. Now it is visible. So in this way you can always change the scale of the dimension. Now we need a circle that is 40 in diameter and the center is 22 meter above this line. Okay, so we will create a circle that is 40 mm in diameter and 22 mm above. So how can we find the center of the circle? So there are various methods. You can simply use a line from this center and with a height of 22. After that you can choose a circle, okay, and specify the center. We have the diameter of 40. So first way is like this. You can specify the reference first, and after that you can create the circle. Okay, but we also have some other options. Okay, so the other option is like this. We can create a circle at this point at the center. Okay, we have the diameter of the next circle is 32. Okay, so circle, we have the diameter 32. So the circle is created. Now if I select the circle, we have the grips. We can select the grip, give the direction and enter the value. We need us at 65 height. So you can see that we can move the circle to the required location like this. You can specify the dimensions again. Okay, and we can specify the dimension like this. Third option is we have an option called tracking. We can track that point without creating a reference, without moving the object. So the tracking command will not work without any command. It will work inside a command. So if I select the tracking command, the tracking command shortcut is TK. If I enter the command here, you can see that it will give an error called unknown command TK. Okay, so this command will always work inside a command when you have to find a point. So I have to create a circle, just select the circle. Now I have to select the center point for the circle. So the center point for the circle is somewhere up in this direction. So I need to find the center, so I have to type the command TK right here. Okay, so tracking command will be applied inside a command, not outside a command. So right now I have to find a center point, so I can type a letter TK and press enter. Now the tracking command is activated. You can see it's saying first tracking point. So we have the first tracking point right here. Now specify the direction in the up side. Okay, you can see this brown color line. Now define the dimension. We need a third circle at height of 111. And press enter. Okay, so we are at a required point. So to exit from the tracking, don't press the escape button, simply press the enter. You can see here, press enter to end the tracking. To get back to the circle, simply press enter, and you can see that we are now back at the circle command with the center specified at the desired position. So now we have to specify the diameter, and the third circle's diameter is 28. So in this way we can create it, the dimension 28 from here and the center point location from here 111. You can see it from here. The third circle is of diameter 28 and is at height of 111. This 155 height is of this circle. Okay. So in this way we can create the whole drawing. Okay, so again we will create another circle that is of 25 dia at a height of 155. So select the circle, select the TK command inside of the command, select the start point, define the direction and enter the value 155. Now we are at a desired position, press enter. Now enter the diameter of the circle. So here it is asking for radius. I have to select diameter. So we need a 25 dia circle. So simply select and hit like. So any question up to this point? Can you create it like this? If you have any question in any command till now, please ask your question right now. Okay. So next we have commands like arcs. So arcs are similar to circles, just trimmed circles. So we can create arcs from these type of options. First we have 3 points. We will need some references to create arcs. So I'm creating a box right here. So first 3 points, we can simply just specify 3 points and our arc will be created. So by creating it with the help of reference, 3 point arc, specify the first point, specify the second point and specify the third point. So our arc will be created like this. Okay, if I select the point from here, first point, I need the midpoint something here, I need the end point something here. So you can select the 3 point arc like this. Next option, you can just read the name and create the arc by using that type. Okay, we will always get the help from AutoCAD. You can see when I go to a specific command, the help option will open here and you can see there is a representation, image representation. You can see how to create the object or how to create the command from that image. So the name specifies start, center, end. We have to set the start point, the center point, and the end point. So I'm going to select the start point from here, the center point from here, and the end point I need here. So in this way we can create a arc. If we want the arc to be inside, then go to that type, select the start from here, center from here, and end according to that. Okay, the arcs work in counterclockwise in AutoCAD. So according to the selection, the direction will be defined. Okay, again, start, center, end, we need 3 point, start point, center point, and end point. Okay, so specify the start, specify the center, I need the arc up to this point, so specify this point. So in this way, you can create a arc. Next option we have is start center angle. If you have an arc that is at an angle, so specifying the start point, specify the center point. Now up to what angle do we want to create this arc? Okay, I need this arc up to 45 degrees, so specify 45 value here. Now you can see this arc is of angle 45 degrees. If you want this arc to be inside, go to the type, specify start upside, enter downside. Now you can specify the angle. I need a 90 degree angle. So this arc will be created here. So if you want to specify the angle, you need to have a reference for that. You have to create a line from the center to the end. Okay. After that, you have to select the dimension from here. Select the line from here and select the line from here. You can see the angle is between 45. You can always select the angle from this or this. Okay, we need this 45 degree, so we will keep here. And after that, we can delete the dimension or we can convert it into the reference. So how can we convert this into reference? We need to apply the properties of line type from here. But by default, we don't have the line type of center line. So we have to go to the other, we have to go to the load option, and we can now select from the standard. We have here the center types. Okay, here we need a center line. So we will select from here. Okay, now you can see the center line is available. Okay, if you select here, now you can see the center is here. So we have to just select the object, go to the line type, select the type to center. If you don't see the shape, if you don't see the line type, just change the property. You have to change the property. You can right click. Okay, you can just right click. Okay, there are few things how you can change the property. You can just go to this arrow right here. You can just press Control 1. Okay. You can just right click and select the properties. Okay, we are not getting the properties from here. Okay, so if you don't get the properties here, simply go to this point. The properties option will be available. If you select any object, that object's property will be shown here. So you can see the line type is center, but the line type scale is 1. If you don't see the size here, just click on the scale, convert the lower down the scale to 0.1 like this. Okay. If you don't see, just go to the scale to 2. Either increase or decrease, you will see the change in one option. So press escape and now you can see it is the center now. Okay, we will cover these properties in the third session or fourth session. Okay, so we will cover step by step everything. Right now, we are just covering these tools, how to create some drawings from draw tools. So these are the options. Okay, so by selecting from here list, you can create any type of. So we are going to just jump to the most used arc, that is start and radius. Okay, so if you have a radius and you have a start and end point, you can always create with the help of that. Right now I want to create an arc here like this. We have the radius. If we want a semicircle, we have the radius of 24. So go to the start and radius with the start but point, click on the center point and select specify. Okay, we need an end point here, not the center. So again, select the start and radius, specify start, specify end, and specify the radius. The radius minimum value required is half of this line. So half of this line is 24. So we'll select, and you can see a semicircle is created. We can increase the angle, we can increase the radius, but not decrease the radius from 24, because minimum radius required is half of this line. We can always increase it like this. If we select the 2 point and increase the radius to 100, this type of arc will be created. But if we decrease the radius from 24, either you use 23.9999, it will not create because it will require minimum of 24 radius. Okay, any question till now? Okay, so next we have some options, like if we want to create a circle of 10 and another circle of 10 but at a distance of 20. So we can just create a circle from this point at a distance of 20. Okay, sorry. Or I want this at the distance of 40. Okay, you can see the distance is between 40 and the radius is, or the diameter is 20. Now if you want to create a line tangent to this circle, these two circles, how can we do that? So if the objects are in the same plane, same axis, we can always create the line by selecting the quadrant. It will always be tangent. If we select a line from this point to this point, it will always be tangent. But if we have the object at an angle, then we cannot select the end point because it will not be tangent. So how can we create a tangent line on two entities? So you have to select the line. Okay, while selecting the line, if you ask for the first point, now we need a tangent point on the circle. So if you click somewhere, it will not be the tangent point. So to create a tangent point, simply select the line. When it asks for the point, simply press the shift button, hold down the shift button and press the right click, and you will see a menu from here. Okay, it will not be available if you press right click. Okay, you have to press the shift and the right click simultaneously, and you will get the option here, the tangent. Then select the tangent. Now if you go to the circle, a tangent relation will be added to the line. We need the line in the upside, so we select the line from here. You can see if you move the line, the tangent will line will be tangent to the circle and move accordingly. Now we need another relation, that is the tangent to this circle. So we have to again specify the type. So press shift and right click, go to the tangent and select the circle. So this line will be created. Okay, so we need another line in this side. Again shift and right click and tangent, select this, again shift right click and tangent. So keep in mind, you need to select in this side. If you select in this side, the line will be created like this. So keep in mind, you have to select in this side, so the object will be created like this. Okay, these type of shape will be used to create pulleys or belts. Suppose these two circles are pulleys, and this is the belt. You have to create it like this according to the tangent. So line command, press the shift, hold the shift key and press the right click. You will get the menu. Now you can select the tangent option from here, and you can create a tangent circle from here. Okay. Any question on line tangent? This command is called line tangent. You want me to repeat? I can repeat. Okay. So next option, we have a drawing. Okay. So these drawings can be created with the tangent. Now these drawings can also be created with the tangent. So you have, you will get an assignment and you have to create those drawings. So these drawings will be available in the assignment. You have to create and submit that assignment. Next we have is how to trim the objects. Okay, so if we have this shape, okay, so how can we create this shape? So first read the drawing. We have two circles there, concentric circles. Concentric means same center. So one is 40 dia, one is 80 dia. Okay, so we will create two circles, and one is of 40 dia, so the radius will be 140 and others 20. You can always enter radius also. Now we have one circle here whose center is 140 mm away from this center, and the radius of that circle is 75. So go to the circle, select the tracking command and select the point, go to the direction and specify the value, and now we can specify the center, the radius, that is 75. And we have the another circle that is 50 mm down here with the radius of 70. So circle, select the tracking, go to the center and with 50 value with the radius of 70. So now we have to cut down the circles from here, and we can do that from the trim command. Okay. Simply select the command trim from here, or you can select the command from shortcut TR. Okay. So when you select the command trim, you will be asked for to select the objects. So you don't need to select the object. You just have to press the enter here and you will get to these options. Okay. This means you have to select the trim and select the enter. Now we will get these options. So now you can simply select the object, or you can simply cross the object and the trim will be created. Or you can just select the shortcut TR. If you press one enter, the select the object option will be shown. You just have to press another enter, and now you have to select the objects like this, and the object will be trimmed. Okay. Now you can check the dimensions here. It's 80, it's 40, its radius is 75, its radius is 70. Okay, so you can see that in the above option we got diameter, in the below we got the radius. So why does this happen? Why didn't we get the diameter here while we are getting the diameter here? It is because this is the complete circle. So complete circles give you diameters, and if the circles are trimmed, they are arcs, then you will go and you will get the radius type dimension. Okay, next we have to specify the distance between their centers like this and like this. Okay, after that we have to create two arcs here. Now you can see that the radius of the arcs are 40, and we don't have the other option. You can see the arcs are tangent to these two circles. So how can you create that arc here that require 40 radius and tangent to both sides? So how can we create this? Tell me, how can we create this? Can anyone answer this? Phillips, okay. Or without fillet? How can we create this without fillet? Okay, the tent and circle. So we have the circle type here, that is two tangent and the radius. Now we can, you can see that the arc is tangent to both sides and the radius we have is 40. So select and select the first tangent, select the second tangent and the radius is 40. Okay, now we have to trim. So select the trim and you can trim it like this. Okay, and same as in other side, just select this and trim. So this would be created like this. So any question related to this drawing, how can we create this drawing? What is the method we use? Ask your queries, please. Okay. So next one we have is rectangular. So you can select from here or you can type REC, the shortcut REC, and enter. Now we have options, five options here. We are not using those right now. We have specify first corner point. So specify the corner from where you want to create the rectangle. I'm clicking here. Now you can see the rectangle can be created like this. If you have two references, just click on that. Okay, like I have a line here. I want a rectangle that starts from here and ends at this point. So go to the rectangle, start from here and click here. So by reference, you can create the rectangle. But if you want to create with the help of dimensions, suppose I need to create a rectangle with the height, with the length of 100 and with the width of 50. So we have to go to the rectangle. We have to specify the first point. Now for the other point, we need to go to the dimensions here. We have the dimension, so we will select the dimension. The length we have is 100 and the width we have is 50. After that, you can see that it is not created yet. It will ask for the quadrant. In which quadrant do you want to create? First, second, third, fourth. Whatever you require, just click on that quadrant and the rectangle will be created. Now you can check the dimension. 100, it's 50. So in this way, you can create a rectangular shape. Okay. Now if you have a area of rectangle, you don't know the length of the rectangle, but you know the area and width of the rectangle, then again you can create. So select the rectangle, go to the first corner point and you can select the area option. Now the area of the rectangle is 20,000 and I know the width of the rectangle, that is 100. So if we select these two, the rectangle will be created like this and the length will be auto calculated. Okay, like this. If you want to check the area, we have the command AA and we can select the object from here. Now you can see the area is 20,000 from here. Okay. So next option is, if you want to create this rectangle, but you want this rectangle at an angle of 30 degrees. I have just shown the area command. If you want to check the area of an object, you have to just select the command from AA, that is area, or you can check the command from, okay, from here it is area. Utilities. In the utilities, we have the measure, in that we have the area option, just go to the objects. You have an object, select the object like this, and the area will be shown here at 2000, 20,000, and the perimeter will also be there. Next, I want a rectangle that is at an angle of 30 degree with some dimension. So go to the rectangle, select the first point. Now select the rotation. Before defining the dimension or the area, simply define the rotation. Okay, and so define the rotation to 30 degree. Now you can see the rectangle is at an angle of 30 degree. Now define the dimension. If you see some values here, like you can see the 200 is already there. I want my same direction, same dimension. Then I can just press the enter. You don't need to enter the value if you see the value is already there. I need this value 100 and value is here. So I can press enter. So then select the quadrant. Just click and the object will be created. So again the dimensions. And to specify the angle, we need a reference line right here. So go to the line, create a line, convert that line to the center line from here. And now you can specify the angle. So to specify the angle, go to the dimension, select the line, select this line. Okay, and you can specify the angle like this. Any questions? Okay, next I'm going to show you how to create a line at an angle. Okay, so to create a line at an angle, simply select the line. It will ask for the first point. Specify the first point. Now I want to specify the angle, length of the line and the angle. So we have multiple options. First we have the coordinate system in which we can create it. Now I need a line at a at an angle of 45 degree and the length of the line should be 50. So for that I can simply type at the rate will initiate an coordinate system that is called relative polar, and I can type the length of the line, it is 50, and I can type the angle symbol. Okay, and I can type the angle. I need a 45 degree angle. So at the rate will initiate that this point is relatively origin right now, and 50 will define the length of the line and 45 will define the angle of the line. So to define the angle, we have to specify the symbol of the angle. Now if I press enter, the line will be created at an angle of 45 degree. You can check that from here that this is the 45 degree angle and its length is 50. Okay, the second method is easier method, that is we have to select the dynamic input method on, like ortho mode. We have a option dynamic mode. If you don't see this option here, you can go to here and select the dynamic input from here, or we have the shortcut that is F12 to turn it on or off. You can see it is off right now. If I press the F12, now you can see it is on. Okay, if I select a line, I can just click the center point. Now we get the length and the angle. So now the blue box is at the length. So if I type the length, you can see the value entry is right now here. So I have defined the 100 value. If you want to just go with the 100, you can press enter. If you want to specify the angle, okay, right now the angle is 26. If you want to change the angle, just press the tab button and the value entry will be shifted to the angle. Now I can specify the angle and press enter. The command, the line will be specified. You can do this any times. You want a line that is of 150 at an angle of 90 degree, so you can specify 100 and press tab to switch and press the value at 90. So you can create it like this. Okay, so if we go to the drawing, like I have a drawing right here. Okay, this drawing starts from the origin 0 0, and there is a length of, the length is not given, we have to calculate. The whole length is 4, this length is 3, then this gap should be 0.5. okay, 3 plus 0.5 plus 0.5 is equal to 4. And next we have this line that is at an angle of 60 degree. The 60 degrees of the angle is at this side. So if we enter 60 degree, the line will be created like this. So we have to check the angle. The angle is from 180 degree line, so we have to calculate. So this line is at an angle of 120 degree and with the length of 2.25. So to create this, we have to go to the software and we will select a line that will be starting from origin 0, 0. Okay. Now we have a line of 0.5 at an angle of 0 degree. You can see that a line of 0.5 is created. Now we have a line of 0.8 at an angle of 270 degree. The line will be created like this. Okay, 270. Okay, we have to specify with the according to the direction. So undo. We need a line of 0.8. Is at an angle of 90 degree. If I click here, then I have to select 270. If I go here, I have to select the 90 degree. Okay, so I'm turning it off right now. So I need a 3 dimension, I need a 0.8, I need a 0.5. okay, so use this option in angular lines only. You don't need to use this option in the straight lines. Now I need a line that is 2.5 mm of length and at an angle of 60 degree from this line. So length is 2.25 and the angle length is 2.25 and the angle I need is should be 120 degree, because from this angle, if we subtract from this 180 degree, if we subtract 60 degree from the 180 degree, we will get the 120 degree angle. Now we have the 4 length line, so ortho and 4 length. And now we have a 1.5 length line with the angle of 30 degree from this line. So we need a 1.5 length. And at an angle of 30 degree from here. So if we calculate from 0, that will be 120 degree. Okay, so again we have 1.5, so between angle is 60 degree right here. So if we check the 60 degree from here, okay, you can see the dimension is right now from this point. So we can type in 120 degree if we check from here. Okay, it is not checking from upside, we need to check it from the downside. So this gap is 60 degree and this gap is already 60 degree, so we need to type in 120 degree angle. We can do the mirror, but we are not going through mirror right now. We will check the mirror command in the next question. So F8, type 4, and right now I can just close this or I can use the angle option. So in this way you can create a drawing. Okay, I think this drawing is wrong. Okay, so we need to check the values. 30 degree. Okay, this is 3. We have done something wrong here.
For 30, we have to give 150.
90 plus 30 is 120. From here, if we see the angle from here, If 30 degree is the angle, then 90 plus 30 degree is 120.
And to the horizontal side.
Just a minute, I have to change the dimension. Modify, I need that to be 1. Okay, set close. Maybe I have created this dimension wrong. Okay, I have typed 1.15, I think. Dimension is 1.5. Okay, I have written the dimension wrong here, 2.25. So this dimension is 2.5, I have written it 2.25. Okay, this is 2.25 and we have given 2.5, that was the error. So we can adjust that, we can delete that, and we can create another line that is of 2.5 at an angle of 120 degree, so it should be here. Okay, so that was the error. We just have to check everything, we just have to move the objects. From here to here. Okay, now you can see that. Okay, after that we will have to create, so it depends on you what method do you want to use. I don't use this method, I use direct at the rate 1.5 at the rate, sorry, angle, and it will be 60, 30 to 40. I prefer the manual method, that is easy method for me. And I will do that. Okay. After, you can see that I have pressed the close option. Now the close is created between these 2 points because I have selected a new line that was starting from here. And after that, I cannot close this point to this point because the new point is started from here. So we have to just create a line from here to there. Okay. So angles will be specified like this. And it can be specified like this. Modify. Okay. So is it clear? Any questions? Okay. Now we are going to cover a new command that is called polygon. So if you want to create a shape that is polygon in nature, like triangle, three sides to triangle, pentagon, hexagon, octagon, similar shapes, then we have the option for that is polygon. So Okay, like this, if you want to create this shape, so you can see we have a circle of radius 5 and we have two triangles in between. So first, how we can create? My side, it's not possible, it will hang from my side. I'm using a broadband system. Can you all see my screen in the motion properly? Is there any problem with my screen? Okay. Neil, it's your internet service is slow, that's why you are seeing my screen slowly. Okay. So, to create a polygon, we have to just go here and select the polygon, or you can select POL, enter, and the polygon command will be struck. The first option will be the number of sides. If you want a triangle, type 3. If you want a pentagon, type 5. If you want to check the limit of the polygon, simply select 2, because you know that with two lines you cannot create any closed loop object. Okay, if we type 2, then you will get an error, require an integer between 3 and 1024. Means you have to choose between these options. The maximum limit of polygon in AutoCAD is 1024 and the minimum limit is 3. So you have to create, you have to choose according to this. So if I want to create a triangle, I will select number of side 3. So there are two options. If you have a radius or you have a length of the line. Okay, so you can see that in this case we have the length of the triangle and all of the sides are equal. So the length of triangle is 60. So for that option we can use an option of edge from here. Okay, if you have the length of the edge, you can use edge option. Then you have to specify the first point and you have to specify the other point. Right now the ortho mode is on. If it is off, then you will see it like this. So you have to turn on the ortho mode so that you can create it according to your position. So I have a length of the line at 100 mm. So I can create a 100 mm length triangle and I can see the dimension from here. So again, modify it. Okay, set current and close. So like this you can create. If you don't have the length but you have the reference, suppose I want to create a triangle and the triangle should be aligned on this line and the triangle should be like this, then I can choose the polygon command, I can choose the sides to 3, I have to choose the edge option from here and press here, turn off the ortho and select this point and the polygon will be created like this. Okay, so there are many options. Just select the polygon, number of sides, edge option. If you have the length, simply specify first point, turn on the ortho, go to the required side and define the value whatever you need. Okay, and all the sides are equal. You can check it like this from here. Okay, we are getting a dimension that is linear in nature. We can go to the aligned and select it like this. Okay, so in polygon all the sides of the object will be same. Next option is like we have a circle and we want the polygon inside the circle, like the polygon should touch at the circle. So for that we have to create a reference circle. I want a circle of 50 radius and I want a polygon, I want a pentagon now that should be inside of this circle. So go to the polygon, select the number of sides to 5. Now we don't have to select the edge option, we need to specify the center point of polygon. So go to this circle, you can now see the center, choose the center. Now we have two options. If you want the polygon to be inside of this circle, select the inscribed in circle and define the radius of circle, that is 50. So you can see the polygon is created like this. Again, number of sides. If you want the polygon to be outside of this circle, then you have to select the circumscribed. So select, define the radius 50. Now you can see the difference between inscribed and circumscribed. This option is inscribed in circle. In means inside of this circle, and this option is inscribed about circle. About means outside of the circle. Okay, so you can create polygons like this. You can create this into reference if you want. So simply go to the properties, select the center, and you can see this is the reference line. Okay, to fully define, just go to the dimension, define the radius or diameter of the circle, and it is fully defined. Any questions? Okay, so last command we have is this ellipse type. So if you want to create an elliptical shape, you have two types to create it. First, we know that ellipse require major axis and minor axis dimension. Okay, like we require a center in the radius or diameter in the circle. What is your question? I didn't understand your question. What is the word before triangle? Scale. You can ask your question. Okay, so we are going to create a polygon. Sorry, we are going to create an ellipse. So first is center option. Triangle with two equal sides. So that we cannot create with the polygon. In the polygon option, all the sides of the polygon will be equal. If you want to create that, you have to create that manually. Okay. So in the ellipse option, we have first center type. In this, we have to specify the center of the ellipse. Then we have to specify the value of first direction and the second direction. Now, remember that in the center option, we have to specify both the values in the half. Okay, suppose I have an ellipse and its first side value is 50 and second side value is 25. Okay, this is an ellipse. The first side of value is 50 from center to this point. Okay, and second value is 25 from this point. Okay, this value is defined from the center and the values are defined as half. If you want to create the ellipse from axis end, now you can see the first type, the first value you should be defining is full and the second value you should be defining is half. Okay. So click here to define full value. You can change the direction. You can also specify the full value in this direction. But remember, the first side should be full. So now I want to create the similar option. First full side should be 100. So define 100. The second should be half. So that will be equal to 25 again. So now this is the axis end type ellipse. Like this. Okay, sometimes we don't need to specify the values. If you have a reference, you just select the reference. The accident will be used in the reference case. like I have a I have a rectangular shape. I need a ellipse here. I don't know the value between the gap. I don't know the between gap. Okay, so we can go to the axis and we can select the two points. Okay, then you need this value. If you have any reference, you can click, or if you want to specify the value, you can simply specify the value like this. Okay, like I have a funnel. Okay, if I want to create an elliptical shape here, so go to the ellipse, axis end. You don't need the value, now you can create it like this. Okay, whatever do you need, just go to and define the value. So you can create it like this. If you want to define the ellipse here, go to the axis end, specify the value like this, and you can also specify it like this. Okay, any questions? So last thing is elliptical arc. So elliptical arc is similar option. First you have to specify the ellipse with the help of axis end or the center. So if I take the center option, you have to specify the value in half. I want the half value 50 by 25. You can see that. Now you have to specify the start angle of the arc. So I want to start the arc from here, and I want the arc to be here. So you can see this is the elliptical arc. You can always control it from here like this, but remember, if you put it in here, the option will be removed. You cannot move it like this. Okay, again you can select the ellipse command from shortcut EL, enter. Next session 3:30 is not for all students. That is a different session. Okay, I think you can ask in the group. They will give you the information. Okay. So shortcut is EL, enter. Okay, and the option is specify axis endpoint of the ellipse. So the direct option you will get from the shortcut is axis endpoint. If you want to specify through center, you can choose that, or if you want to take the R command from here, you can always select that. So I am going to create an arc, elliptical arc from shortcut. So again, you have to select from axis endpoint or center. I'm going to select the center. So I'm specifying the values 100 by 25, and I want my angle to be started from 15 degree to be to the end of I want it 200. Okay, so you can see that my elliptical arc starts from this 15 degree and goes up to the 200. So can you check the angle, specify, go to the dimension, select the two lines. So it is 15 degree, and you can see this angle is 160 degree from here. So if you subtract from 360, you will get the 200 angle from right here. So in this way, you can create an elliptical shape. Okay, you can create an elliptical arc, and you can create the ellipse with the help of references. So we have created our session. If you have any queries, please ask your questions. And yes, don't leave the session. I'm going to take the attendance right now. So attendance, I will take the screenshot. You don't have to say anything. I'm going to just click the picture from here. So we have 25 participants today. Okay, change it from the next session. In this session, I will check and enter there. Okay, so about that assignment, I will show you a sample assignment, and you will have to create, and you will have to create those assignments, and you have to submit me the assignment. First, I will show you how to save your file. So when you complete your file, simply go to the file and select save, or you can go here, select save. If you want to rename it, you can always go to save as and define where you want to save this. I want to save it on the desktop, and you can say I have a drawing one name. So you have to specify the name, specific name. If you got the assignment one, you will specify A1 for assignment one. If you got the assignment two, you will specify the A2. Then you will specify the drawing number. So we will specify D and drawing number 1, 2, 3, whichever is there. Suppose D1 for drawing 1, D2 for drawing 2. So save, and your file will be saved. Now go to the folder where you have saved. Now you can see that I have saved. Okay, from A1. Okay, this is our file. You will got a different icon here. My icon is different because it is considering it the SolidWorks e-drawing file, but you will got the AutoCAD symbol here. So you have to mail this file to us. Okay, you can create multiple drawings in a single sheet, or you can create multiple drawings in different sheets. Okay, then you have to select all the files and mail to us. So what is the mail address? So you will got an assignment like this. Okay, so in the assignment you will get an email ID. Okay, read the first page. This assignment is for Creo. I will show you in the next session the AutoCAD assignment. You will get in half an hour or in an hour. You have to read the instruction first. So you have to submit your assignment on the next day before midnight. Okay, today is your session, so you have to submit tomorrow before midnight, and you have to mail the assignment to email ID that have specified in that assignment. There is creo.scicad, so you will got autocad.scicad. Okay, in the subject you will have to mention your name, your roll number that we have provided you. If you are studying in a college, you have to mention the college name and assignment one. Okay, whichever assignment is given to you, please write down that in the subject. After that, you will be given some drawings, some instructions will be there. You will just read the instructions and create drawings according to those. Okay, you will be given 3 to 4 drawings, and you have to create all the drawings. And please submit that before midnight. Okay, how to install the software? So we have provided you the link of the software, how to download. Okay, the installation process is easy, the download process is difficult. So download your software, simply just double click on that and you will get the installation procedure. You have to just select the next option, and you will got some product key. You have to enter the product key on that. Okay, any other question, any other query, please ask right now, or I'm going to close the session after that. If you face any problems, please message in the group. You can always ask the questions, the queries in the group, and we will solve that. Okay, someone asked a question. I'm not understanding that. Okay, camera. So I have turned off the option of the camera right now. That's why you are not able to show your camera. Okay. Because everyone was starting their camera and I'm seeing all the videos right here. So I have turned off the camera option. Okay. Any other question? Email subject should be, I have told you, email subject should be the name, your roll number, your college name. Okay. You will get it from here. Okay. This is the sample. You can see here. Look, subject should be your name, your college, your roll number. Roll number that we have assigned you. Okay. And the assignment number here. Okay. Thank you. That's it for the today. Okay. Thank you.